Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I will show you how to download, install and start using JabRef. So first you have to go to Google or your web browser. In web browser you just JabRef, then you'll get this page, the welcome page of JabRef software. You click on download. So here you take the version you want to use. Usually use this one, you download it. So after download it, you'll get the setup. Then the installation is a step by step installation. So when you click here, you download the version according to your which version you are using your operating system. So we use Windows, you click on here and the downloading is going. So it's almost done. You keep it because you don't want to see it as a virus, so this way you ask. Then after install it, you just run it. Yes, because Windows 10 is don't know the publisher, but is a good software and a secure one. Don't worry about it. Run anyway. Then the installation interface will come. Next, you go where you want to put it, the installation folder. By default, just left it as C program file. If you want to change, you can change to any directory. Then, so you see that it already exists. I just want to show you, no, I have already JabRef, so I don't have to install it again. No, so cancel. Yes, then after installation, you can find it here on your desktop. JabRef, just tap Jab, you'll find it here on the Windows program. The search Windows. Then you open it. See, now you open it. Now you don't have any document here, so you just go to new library. Like we are creating a new library, you can also save the library. For instance, you go here, save as. Save library anywhere. For instance, just put it test JabRef and save. Here we don't have any reference. Now if you want to add references, you have to go to search the title of your paper you want to add, you want to download. For instance, suppose I type this title of the paper, that's my paper, I get it here. Then I go to site. The site will come. Oh, I didn't connect to my VPN for Google. So you go to your site again. Then site will come. Then here I go to BibTeX. So I select all, control A, or just you do like this, you select all, you copy, or control C. Then after copying, you come to your JabRef, you go to your add article. You click on add, it will open. So by default you open like this. See, it is hard to add author name, title. No, you just come here. This will take time to add all this information. You come on BibTeX source, that's why we choose BibTeX. Then here by default you put the type of the paper is article, so you can delete all. You just delete all, or like this, just delete everything. Then you pass what you have copied, pass. And now you save, control S, or you come here to save. See, so just control S. After control S, I mean push control S, you try to save. You see, after saving, you find the here. It automatically you put the author name, the title, the year of the paper, and the journal or the book title. And this is the citation key. You will see important why this key is important. It should be unique so that it will identify all references. So here you add. If you want to add more reference, same thing. You go to Google, you put the paper is the paper title. For instance, let's we do another one. For instance, we want to add this one, this paper title. Same thing, you search it on Google. You got it here. Then you come here, cite again. BibTeX. You select all. You copy it. You come again, new one. And you also delete everything here. You pass. So you see, and you save, Control S to save. Or you just come here, F, save. So it's the same. You see, after you save automatically, he come with the second one. So he ordered by year. You see, you can change the order. It depends on what you want. You can change the order of the, or by title, A, B, C, D. It depends on what you want. So here you have two. See more and more and more until you get all your referencing. You see, and here there's some option. You see, automatically he puts the title of the paper, the author of the paper, the title, the journal. And here you can even ask, add the abstract of the paper. So this, you just add your reference and you manage everything. You can also attach a file. Let me see. Let me see. Yeah, attachment. So this is a document. So this version don't have, it's not so this is a relative, article, but what you download here have abstract, you have general. Okay, this is the way to, okay, files here, you can general file, you see, you can attach the file like the PDF file directly or download directly from internet. So, but this one personal me, I just left the user because I have the file. As we tell you in the presentation, you can save a file by the author name, but you can also add it a file from your desktop. You copy, for example, the PDF that you want to attach to this file, to this to this paper. You just, for instance, let me see if I can find a, for instance, just any PDF. You see, open, then it is here. It has a PDF name here, but it's not so important. So what's important is to get your references here. Now, if you want to cite the referencing, for instance, for those who are using Word, for instance, you want to cite, you are writing something. You say, for instance, in this paper, in paper one, what people do is the author prove that something patata patata. So then you come down in the reference page, you do like this, what some people do, and now you copy the reference of the paper, like what people do. You come here, for instance, go to text here, you copy this, and the people come and the past here. So some many students did it or are doing it. So you see, this take time, you don't have to do this. If you are using, for instance, Office Word, you open reference management. Sorry, you have to first like export this one is Let's say export. All. Then now, if it's exporting, you have to take. Let me save it on, for instance. Here, so you give it name. For instance, you have to save it in MS Office 2007. You have to take this option because you have main option by default. So we take this option. Then you give a name. For instance, just again test Jab. You give a name. Test demo. So just say demo. I write demo. So, and you save it because you export, you want to put it in OAuth. After save it there, you know where you save it. You come here, reference management. Then you go to browse to take what you have saved and where you is a file demo is in here. And you go to demo, this file. Yes, okay, we select it. You see, automatically he show you all the references that you have adding in JabRef. Then now you select all. You select all, you copy to the current, because this is the source. The current list is mean here in your citation file, in your office file. You add all, copy. Then after you copy it, then now you can close it. So now if you want to say something, for instance, in this paper, in rather than say in one, no, you come here, you want to cite, you go okay, you go to insert citation, you see, you choose which one, because we remember you have just add two citation. For instance, I want to say this one, automatically it put this one. Then now you can add the author, the party, the patata, you see. Second one, for instance, is say, for instance, you say a sentence. A research is important. Dun, 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 dun. Then you want to give reference, but who you have to put the no? You just delete again. You put now the reference you want to cite. Find the second one. Then automatically add two. So this is how to cite it in your text. So now to find the reference part like this one, you put references to find it. And to insert it, you just come here, a bibliography, you go to reference, you assign references. So you see automatically he adds the reference we put in the text. So you see, he said automatically, you don't have to add anything. You put automatically more references, you add the text, you find it more in the reference part. You see, this is how to add reference using JabRef in Word. Now the style according to the journal or your paper or which, however you have many style. Usually in engineering we use IEEE. So this we by default IEEE style. For instance, if you change this one automatically, see the reference also change is auto this. You can find Chicago again. You see, so according to which type of reference you choose. So we come back to our IEEE by default. So that is it for Office Word user, sorry, Microsoft Office user who want to use JabRef. So now, but for those who use for example LaTeX for text editor, this for instance, this is a LaTeX file. For instance, this is a LaTeX office. So maybe if someone to know how to install, you can, I will try to do another video about how to install LaTeX also. So for instance, for this user, for instance, suppose I want to make citation here, just I put something so that you see the type patata patata, then I run it. Okay, let me put color so that it will be clear that this one I have add. Let me put a color, for instance, color red for this part. First I put let me put this color red. So so that it people see exactly where I added. Oh, sorry. Let's see, in ground. Let's see, run it. Oh, two. So, yeah. Okay. Oh, what is this? Oh, my, yeah, is a color style. So, you see, is this part. Let's make it big. It is that I have add in both colors. So, if I want to do this citation here, what I do here, JabRef come according to the editor. For instance, I want to cite this in my LaTeX. So, you see here, there is many kind of text editor according to here I use a text maker. So if you come here, you can find text maker. If you didn't find it according to your LaTeX editor, you will find it, and you just go choose the LaTeX editor you want. Here by default I have directly the text maker, so when I say add, he push it directly in my LaTeX. Then when I come here, see, automatically he say site, you see. So now, if you don't do like, if you know the index, for instance, as I say here in the LaTeX, you see, there is what you call the index key. This is the key, it's important. For this one also, I can come here, I take just the key. I copy the key, then I come here on text, then here, I pass it here. For instance, I just say here, cite, I put, you will cite it too. Then now, you have to go to here, you take BibTeX, you compile it. You compile. Okay, I forgot something to tell you. Because this file has name, so you have to put the name, the file name of your reference. For instance, this is the style of the reference. So those who use LaTeX, they know how to use this one, where to find the referencing about the paper. And your file name should be at the same like the folder of the LaTeX. So this just for LaTeX user. For those who want, for Microsoft users, you don't have to be boring by this thing. But for LaTeX users, they know what I'm saying. So if you want to cite something, you just have to put the bibliography you want to use. Then now, after you compile it, you can find. So I have to give the name. Let me give the right name of the, because you have different. Yeah, let me open this one, this reference paper. It'd be easy, because see, this the name is paper. This is what I have put here in the. Let's remove this citation. So from here, as I see, you have to give the name of the bibliography. Just let's research. To go faster, yes, this paper, you see, the name of the, exactly what is here, the paper. So if I want to cite something, I just select, then I go to insert and push the citation. Then he push it directly, you see, he push it close to the reference. But I don't want to put this here, I want to put where I put the tatata. That let me go to my that sentence directly by searching it. I want to just to find it where I add it to is here. Here I want to cite, as I say, I can do cite, or I come on my reference, then I push it. And now after I push it, you see, directly he add this reference. But now if I compile and I run, you see, okay, I have to run again. Sometimes you have to compile two or three times. Let me see if the same. Okay, let me, yes, compile again. because it's a new reference, this why. So this why sometimes you just wait until you finish every reference citation. Then you see it come now directly 42. So of course there is a way to compile directly all. So that is what you want to show about how to JabRef in Office Word and in LaTeX for LaTeX user and for Office Word user. So that is all for this tutorial. Thank you for watching this video, and thank you to subscribe to my YouTube channel.